Davey De La Garza. Davey is a writing and rhetoric major, and he's graduating next Saturday. His area of concentration while at St. Edward's was creative writing. And a fun fact, he has drunk beers in a dozen countries and written poetry in the middle of the Pacific Ocean. Here's Davey.
Hello, everyone. Thanks for coming out. My first poem is entitled Violence. I wait patiently for someone to attack. The sight of violence is my morning coffee. It's usually best if it's someone you don't know, but family will do in a pinch. If you're a professional, you drop bombs. There are people who will pay you for that. Yesterday, my psychiatrist just wrote murder on a prescription pad. He told me it's surprisingly cathartic and showed me some instructional videos. I wanted to bring up something about love, but our time was up. He handed me a gun on my way out, along with a guide to responsible use. I was lucky enough to find a stranger before I made it home. He was nervous at first, but I explained it was doctor's orders. He was sympathetic. He died with understanding in his eyes. I began to feel relief, then a man stabbed me while he whispered, "I'm sorry." I wanted to tell him it was all right, but I just caught blood all over his face. He wiped me with his sleeve. But I could see the joy on his face now that he chose violence over love. So that poem, I read that one first because that was kind of the first one that I wrote in this series. When we started this project, I had an idea of what I thought I would do with it. But then I wrote that poem and I was like, oh, well, that works. I like the tone of it because I've kind of wanted to write about like social issues, but I get kind of personal. And that one somehow managed to detach myself from it and be more observant with it, and I thought it worked. So that's kind of the title of my chapbook is Visions. That's just like things that I noticed. This one's titled Complacency. It doesn't kill you fast. It's more subtle than that. You might not notice a thing, but after some time has passed, the light is not as bright. Croissants are less flaky. You don't laugh at the same shows. You look at knives in a different way. If this sounds familiar, let me know. Years pass like days. You wait, wait, wait for just one thing. Before you know it, the news anchors have changed. You're not dreaming at night or in the day. You only say, good, when asked how you're doing. Then it's over. And I will read one more. This one's titled Beauty. I've always wanted six-pack abs, jawline like a granite edifice, a smile infectious as the plague. Then I'd want someone to see my daunting beauty and affirm it to me, because what's the use of being pretty if no one else sees? If all else fails, I can fix myself up, crack some bones, make some cuts, splice out the bad parts, replace them with godlike perfection so I gleam when the light hits me just so. I'd be a beauty then. Walk down the street, counting heads that swivel, foregoing my intellect to vocalize the inane dribble expected from the physically flawless. I could be a beauty when my face replaces my words, when people kill for me, when I kill me for it. I'd also be a beauty if I didn't believe any of this shit.